Hi, I'm Phil Felgner, Director of the Vaccine Research and Development Center at UCI, and this is your UCI COVID Minute for March 7, 2022. You asked, why does the booster give some people side effects? And what about myocarditis? A reliable way to induce a powerful immune response against an infectious virus is to get infected by the virus. We all know from experience what happens when we get infected. We feel sick and experience muscle pain, joint pain, temperature, and headache. The virus doesn't directly cause all these symptoms. The symptoms we experience are in many cases caused by the nonspecific inflammatory response our immune system mounts against the acute infection by releasing cytokines. Immunologists refer to this as the innate response. We experience similar symptoms after we get vaccinated, but without risk of infection. The innate response is necessary to trigger the adaptive response, leading to virus-specific antibodies that neutralize and clear the infection. All of our effective vaccines induce an innate immune response, producing transient symptoms without causing an infection. At this time, we don't know how to develop effective vaccines that don't induce innate responses. It is natural for our immune system to induce and recover from innate immune responses, and we do so naturally every year. As for myocarditis, an inflammation of the heart muscle, a small number of vaccine-induced cases have been reported without further short-term or long-term consequences. Again, we are impressed by the knowledge that after billions of doses have been administered worldwide, an overwhelming amount of evidence demonstrates that these vaccines are remarkably safe and effective.